With the GTEC E180 I got a very compact 3D printer from my sponsor GearBest. The print volume is 13x13x13cm and the device is advertised as an easy to handle printer for beginners. The print bed is not heated and the maximum temperature of the hot end is limited to 245 degrees Celsius by firmware, PLA is the best plastics for use with this machine. Compared to the bad smell of ABS, PLA is a relatively environmental friendly plastics while printing, I am using this material almost exclusively. The printer ships completely assembled and the mechanics is protected by a robust plastics housing. The Y-axis is guided by plastic wheels running along an aluminum square profile. There is no noticeable backlash and the axis runs smoothly from end to end when operated manually. The two plastic rolls on the inside also serve as deflection pulleys for the toothed belt. On my device I had an issue with the X-axis. There was too much hot glue used to fix the cables, the printhead gets stuck on a glue knob and so can't reach the endpoint. I removed all of that hot glue and put only a blob on the middle of the axis to keep the cable in place. Now the X-axis moves smoothly from end to end along the 6mm round bars guided by linear ball bearings. After loosening 4 screws on the bottom plate, you can see the tidy interior of the printer. A STM32 microcontroller with a clock speed of 72MHz is used as CPU. The motor drivers are plugged on the mainboard so that those parts can be replaced easily in case something goes totally wrong. After removing a side panel you can see the mechanics of the Z-axis that runs along 3 6mm round bars guided by linear ball bearings driven by a spindle. The whole mechanics seems to be very sturdy. You can replace the hot end with a 0.4mm nozzle easily by unlocking the device through a tiny lever and pulling it out afterwards. Reinserting the hot end is done quickly as well. With that a clogged nozzle is easy to fix. A spare nozzle is part of the package because you can't source this special GTEC part just around your corner. If you don't start with disassembling your printer as I did, you only have to assemble the filament holder with 4 screws. After plugging in the power cable and turning the printer on, the main menu appears on the 3.2 inch touchscreen. My first attempt to control the axis through the printer menu failed. Whenever I tried to move an axis, the touchscreen turned to black and the printer was rebooting. That's obviously an error in the firmware because the motors run perfectly in all other modes. You can operate the printer without moving the axis through that function. For example, you can command all axes to their end switches with the menu. The end switch of the Z-axis is atypically on top. Next thing to be done is leveling the build plate, which starts by searching the screw heads under the blue tape and adjusting the plate to a low position. You can command the printer to the corner points of the build plate through the printer menu, which simplifies the leveling procedure. As usually, the build plate is raised in several runs, starting with a gap of approximately 2mm in the first step, until no more but a sheet of paper fits tightly between nozzle and build plate in the final run. To feed the printer with PLA, you must preheat the hot end to 200 degrees Celsius. As soon as the target temperature is reached, you can insert the filament by pushing a tiny lever on the extruder motor. Pull in filament until a strand of plastics exits the nozzle. Now the printer is prepared for its first job. Print data is transmitted to the device through a micro SD card, even if the reader that is unfavorably on the backside of the printer is labeled TF. The card comes with a file named 424.gcode stored on the device. That's what I'm using as a first test. After selecting the file, the printer moves the Z axis to a low position. The printer starts the job as soon as the target temperature of 210 degrees Celsius is reached at the hot end. The first layer is very important. It must stick perfectly on the build plate so that the object won't get loose while printing. The aluminum build plate is covered with blue tape to make that layer stick on the surface. The printer ships with a second sheet of blue tape, however you can get replacement in any hardware store around your corner. The object grows layer by layer. I'm using this print job to demonstrate a feature of the E180. You can resume a print job after a power failure. Here I pulled the plug while the print head was on the edge of the sculpture. You can see that still some plastics exits the nozzle, forming a knob on the surface while the hot end cools down. As soon as the power is up again, you can resume the print job. The printer commands all access to the end switches immediately. It would be better to heat up the hot end before doing so to avoid the nozzle from breaking free from the cold plastics knob the hard way. As soon as the target temperature of the hot end is reached again, the printer continues with the job. The second functionality that is advertised is a filament sensor. That's what I wanted to demonstrate next, however the printer did not pause the job when running out of filament. When having a close look at the extruder motor, I could not see a switch and there's obviously no place for such a sensor, that's why it can't work. To get the filament out, you must unlock the Teflon tube by pushing the ring and pulling out the Teflon tube afterwards. Now you can pull out the filament and reinsert the Teflon tube. Having a filament sensor would be nice, all you can do without that switch is pausing the job manually before running out of filament. So let's try to print the 424 sculpture for the second time. To save plastics and to speed up the print process, the infill of the object isn't solid but a square pattern. The inner structures are printed with a speed of up to 80 mm per second. The outer perimeters with only 45 mm per second. The layer height is set to 0.2 mm. It took approximately 6 hours to finish the print. The adhesion on the print bed is, as you can see, perfect. The result is a dog sculpture. I'm no expert for Canidae, but considering the color, I guess it's a golden retriever. The print quality is good. All details of the dog that has a height of approximately 12 cm are clearly visible. You can see strings at the bottom edge of one of the ears. There is an overhang having an extreme angle which is a problem for filament printers in general, not only for the G-Tech E180. Usually a removable support structure is printed to avoid the deviations seen here. The surface of the dock is closed, there are no visible gaps between layers. As shown at the print process, the outer shell is printed with a thickness of only 2 layers. As usually, you can have a look at high resolution photos of my sample prints on my pages. I really like the result. Another printer test is a cube with an edge length of 30mm. The layer height is set to 0.2mm. The print speed of all structures is set to 40mm per second. The cube is used to test for vibrations along the horizontal axis. You can see wavy patterns at the edges of the Y, that unwanted effect is called ghosting or ringing. The ringing is lower at the X because the moving masses along that axis are lower as well. When reducing the print speed of the outer parameters to no more than 20mm per second as I did in the second run, that effect disappears. In 3D printing, it's all about finding the best parameters. As entertainment for consumers, you can connect the printer to wireless LAN and transmit templates stored on internet servers. My channel is for makers, which is why I pass up testing those gimmicks. Even children should be taught how to use a 3D printer as a tool for creators, rather than using it for nothing but making dull copies of sculptures. So I am starting to create and print add-ons for the E180. Creating cylinders and cubes with intersections is child's play. The result is a filament holder you can mount on the housing of the printer. You should not break the objects free as I did with the dock sculpture if you notice that they stick too good on the build plate. Use a scrapper instead and even with that tool, the blue tape gets damaged, however you can replace that with ease. Also not very difficult to design is the handle that I'm printing next with the E180. I'm using orange colored filament to make clear that those add-ons are not part of the printer package. Finally, I'm printing a holder for the power supply. The temperature of the hot end is set to 215 degrees Celsius, which is very high for PLA. On the one hand, the temperature sensors used in 3D printers are not that precise and on the other hand, the environmental temperature in my video studio is currently no more than 12 degrees Celsius. As said before, 3D printing is never click and forget, but requires to find the best parameters methodically, step by step. In order to mount the add-ons, you must open the housing, which is done quickly by removing the side panel that is just snapped in. Now you can drill the needed holes and mount all parts with 3mm nuts and bolts. The result is a printer you can easily carry with you. You might have recognized that I redesigned the filament holder because the spools simply did not fit on my first design, well, that happens when doing prototyping. The GTEC E180 is a compact device that is easy to operate and the prints are okay, I can recommend the printer even for beginners or people that just want to print instead of experimenting a lot with 3D printing. The E180 opens the fascinating world of 3D printing so that you can start doing prototyping or use it as a second printer you can easily carry with you. The print volume is sufficient for many projects and my mantra is smaller is better. The E180 occupies only a small area on your desk and you can quickly put it away whenever it is no longer needed. With the add-ons I made, you can grab the printer with one hand and take it with you in order to show a larger audience what 3D printers can do. Another advantage is that the mechanics and the hot end are covered and so widely out of reach for the hands of children or adults that are immune to your warnings. You can read more about the E180 and have a look at high resolution photos of the sample prints on my pages. Thanks for watching and I'll be back!